Hi and welcome to this video. In this video, you will write your very first basic C program. This program will introduce you to few terms which will be used in 99% of the programs. So watch this video with full attention. Now open up Atom and open an empty file by pressing the key shortcut Ctrl plus N. Now firstly, save the file. Let us save this file on desktop and let us give it the name my first program and the file extension .c. Now the Atom knows which language code we will be writing, so it will show customized and selective features to us. For example, it will provide us with code completion suggestions and it will also properly do the syntax highlighting according to the C standards. Now write the exact same program like me, and I will later tell you in detail about each line of code. Now firstly, let us run the program by pressing the F5 key. So you can see the output in the command prompt. We just printed an English quote in a line. So now let us get back to the code and understand how we achieved this. Now basically, a simple C program is a group of functions out of which one is the main function. So that means in the beginning stage, all of your code will contain at least one function whose name is main. So whenever you run your program, the C runtime environment calls this main function, and whatever code you have written inside the function will be executed line by line. So point number one, write all of your code in the main function for now. With time, in later videos, we will learn how to divide our code across different functions and even among different source code files. For now, we are concentrating on a single source file and a single function program. Now, to print a line on the screen, you need to give your program the ability to do that. And these abilities are written in a file named stdio.h. So, the stdio.h has all the functionality to print a line on the screen and even to accept an input from the command line. It has more abilities also, but we will largely concentrate on these two. So, to let our program use these abilities of stdio.h to print a line on screen, we use the preprocessor directive #include written on line 1. So, the syntax #include stdio.h written inside angle brackets imports the code of stdio.h into our file. So point number two, use the code #include angle brackets stdio.h to include the abilities of printing a line on screen. For now, just cramp this syntax. Now on line 3, I have written int main and parenthesis. So as I told earlier, all our basic programs will contain a main function. So here we are doing just that, we are defining the main function. The empty parenthesis around it, that is round brackets, tells the compiler that it is a function. The int written before main is a return value of the main function, which is returned to the system once our main has completed execution. For now, don't worry about it, just write it the same way in which I have written. When we will learn about functions, then we will understand everything nicely. After main function, we are writing a left or opening curly bracket. And on line 5, I have written a right curly bracket or closing curly bracket. So, a group of an opening curly bracket and a closing curly bracket forms a block of code. So, we are forming this block to indicate that whenever our main function is called, execute this code block. A code block can contain any number of code lines. So now whatever code we will write inside this code block will be executed whenever main function is called by the system. Now to print a line on the screen, we need to use a different function which knows how to print it. So the function printf written on line 4 has the ability to print a sentence on screen. So just like the main function, we have parenthesis, that is round brackets, for the printf function. And in its parenthesis, we will write our sentence within double inverted commas. So point number 3, everything written inside inverted commas in the printf function call will be printed on the screen as it is. So the sentence "practice makes you perfect" will be exactly printed on the screen. Now let us run again to see the output. So press F5 to run the program. So as you can see, the exact sentence which we wrote within double inverted commas is printed on the command line. Now one important note over here, a line of code is considered to be a statement in C programming. And all statements in C are ended with a semicolon. So that's why I have written a semicolon after the printf statement. So let us summarize what we have learned in this video. So we learned that all C programs begins with a call to the main function. Everything written inside the main's opening and closing curly braces will be executed one by one. To print a line on the screen, we use the printf function, and the printf function is defined inside the stdio.h file. Hence, to give our program the ability to use the function printf, we import the stdio.h file by using #include preprocessor directive. Now, don't worry if you think that this is very much to swallow. In future videos, you will understand each and every single term in details. So just follow this code style and you should be okay. So thanks for watching this video. Meet you in future video.